What's up, guys? This is HotIH7RCT bringing you another video for you guys. Since the streams are going to be a little bit on the low end, still going through some stuff, but soon I will have news updates on when I'm going to start doing streams again on a more regular basis. For the time being, the whole situation back in Puerto Rico is still the same, mostly. At least most of my friends and family over there are doing well, so to speak. So I'm hoping and trying to do my best to help them as much as possible while I'm still trying to maintain work over here. And of course, the gaming related stuff, which is why I'm here today. Let me bring this down. The reason I'm doing this game in particular for you guys, Dragon Ball Z Xenoverse 2 for the Switch. As you guys know, my avatar, my RCT avatar, is a kind of a modified a version of Super Saiyan 4 Goku. To better match, who I am, because I really identify with this character. I've been a longtime fan of the Dragon Ball series as a whole. Not really much of a fan of the first one, of the Dragon Ball, the one where you see Chibi Goku, or Goku as a little kid. As good as that one was, I kind of was more into the more modern take on it, which was Dragon Ball Z at that time. The thing with the fights and how everything escalated took anime viewing, at least for me, to a whole nother level back at that time. So yeah, I am still at this point a Dragon Ball fan, and it's basically my second favorite series after Berserk, all-time favorite. So yeah, I have a particular, everybody has their own choices and stuff, because there's a lot of people who hate Goku as a character, because we have to admit the guy is kind of dumb. However, the thing that really drew to me to the series and still keeps me going to the series is part of the same reason why I kind of like Star Wars as a whole. And it's because it shows how much you can achieve if you set your mind to succeed, to, go against evil, etc., etc. And this character from my avatar, going back to that, because I don't want to go into a tangent here. Why Super Saiyan 4? Basically, this one is my favorite take or transformation of Goku. Even though we're seeing right now with the new series, Dragon Ball Super, we're seeing some new transformations that go beyond the Super Saiyan 3 that we left behind in Dragon Ball Z. But the thing with the Super Saiyan 4, aside from it being kind of like the redheaded stepchild from all of his transformations in Dragon Ball, because this is motive of another, this is a topic for another video completely, which I'm not going to get too much into. I just want to explain why I like so much this character and this transformation in particular, enough for me to use it as an avatar to represent me in RCT. Now, Super Saiyan 4, of course, is not the most favorite one. Just by proxy, by not being the most popular one, I kind of gravitate towards that. The other thing is, this is the only transformation that I see that is so emotionally involved. Why emotionally involved? Because when he transformed to this, not only was he very, very small, because he went through the whole Dragon Ball wish where they wished that he would go back to being a little kid and stuff like that, so he had unsurmountable odds in order for him to make this transformation. The fact is that they use the golden ape myth, to facilitate his transformation. The fact that his transformation is pretty beastly and literally, because it has his tail, is the only transformation that uses a tail that harkens to that part of the ape side of the Saiyan race. And of course, he's just damn cool. I mean, when you see him transform for the first time, it's like he is so enthralled in this newfound power that he starts doing Kamehamehas with one hand and basically not even putting effort into it. He just, you know, lowers his hand like that and phew, here you go. So yeah, even though it's a redheaded stepchild from the series, because it's not official canon, it's not Akira Toriyama, I still love this version. And we will go now into the game, because come on guys, I took how much? Oh my god, I took 5 minutes talking about that. Oh my god, okay. So yeah, the game. And why on Switch? I mean, you have this on PlayStation 4 and Xbox One. I had the first one on PC, but for some reason, I kind of gravitated when I found out that this was going to come out for Switch. I said, this is a golden opportunity. This is like, you know, I can get back to Dragon Ball. I can play this in portable mode. I can do so many things. I can really get into it because I'm more focused on the Switch now and on PC than I was. Oh my god, like since the very beginning, the games are starting to flow in, which is great. Now, I wanted to do this before, but again, I've been so busy as of late that I didn't get a chance. And ironically enough, last night I completed the game, at least the story part of it, without even me knowing. I think I was so between this and hacking the SNES Mini, which I am going to do a video for you guys, an update video that shows everything, how it works, and running the games. I actually ended up completing the game last night, but there's still so much to do, which is basically the point of this video, showing you how much you can do in this game and how well it runs, of course. Now, right here, since the beginning of the game, you already have me with that intro music. That intro music is badass. No. Of course, that's another thing. I'm only going to cover the offline aspect of it, because, believe it or not, I put in basically 2 weeks of gaming time into this game, and I still haven't tried out the online. I really haven't bothered. Not really interests me at this point, because the game has so much for you to do that I really don't want to stray away too far from it just to go online and start, you know, doing stuff online. Well, this is my character right here. As you can see, I model him as close as it's the game allows me to model it after the avatar from RCT. I've been trying my darnest to get the Goku, the Goku Super Saiyan 4 wig and tail as an accessory, so he can have that. But basically, my character is a badass. He's a badass. What you're gonna see here, first off, let me show you guys. At this point, I can fly, but in the beginning of the game, you only have like a mode of transportation, which is, you know, kind of local. You can mess around and choose different vehicles to move around the hub. It's a pretty big hub for you to go around and mess around, either in the air, down below, mid-level. As you can see, I can already fly, but you are not given that option from the beginning. And there are so many different places that you can go. Get a whole bunch of items and stuff that you can. Now, I'm not going to go into the core of everything that you have to do, because there's a lot. I'll just show you here really quick with my play data. Basically, here it shows how much stronger I've become. The time patrol quest completion is at 91% here, the overall. But when you go into here, you can see that the time patrol quest completion says 100%. Now, it says 100%, but there is some stuff that I still haven't done. As you see there, Hercules' house progress is at 80%. Once I do that 20% that's left on there, I think I gotta do a 50-hit combo or something like that, then that overall progress should hit the 100% ratio. Now, as you can see, my highest combo is 46 hits, so I'm 4 short to reaching that one right there. I'll try to figure something out now. But what can you do here? Well, there's a good amount of stuff. You have the overall map here. With you have the list of kind of like the guide there. You have the red flags, which are story events. You have the quest events, which are highlighted with a blue exclamation mark. Expert missions, which I haven't done any since the first two tutorial ones, so I have some stuff to do there. Time rift events. Those are specific locations that you go and do some side missions, and in the end they'll give you an egg. Don't ask. Instructor events, which is awesome because those little pink houses that you see all around the map, those are different instructors, and those instructors will take you as a student and give you some movesets for you to add to your own repertoire. So that's really cool. You get to, I've trained already with Vegeta, with different characters, Gohan, oh my god, Gotenks, Hit, even the newer ones, Whis, what's the other one, oh my god, there's so many of them that you can just go and learn their movesets. They're going to give you specific stuff to do, like this one right here. I have Magnum Boo that you can go right up to and talk to him, and you can actually train. Yahoo! See, all of them give you an initiation test and a little movement reward, small reward, for passing that initial test. Let's do it here so I can show you guys. But basically, it breaks down into story quests, the main story quests, which are the red flags. You have purple flags, which are the legend quests, which is basically the first game broken down for you to play each and every one of them. And the farther you go into the story mode of 2, you get to open up more missions for the legend quest. Now here I gotta do a specific set of stuff. So here I'm gonna learn Innocent Bullet, which is one of his moves. And it's a poison move. Nice. So, as you can see, that was a move right there. I gotta apply it to him. Ooh, I missed him. As long as I apply it once, I'm golden. What are the energy hands here? Consecutive energy blocks. Thing is, while you're learning with an instructor, you can't use your own moveset. They choose certain movesets for you, so you're stuck with that. Lesson is over. I gotta wrap this up. And there you go. I passed it. So by passing that initiation, we get a chance to either train or have him be a specific your instructor. Your instructor kind of gives you bonus moves and stuff like that. And I get a new super attack, a TP metal, which is used for buying stuff. At the local stores. So after doing that, see, the game tells you that you have a new event or a new class. That's basically telling you that you can go and take your next lesson, I guess. Now, something I want to show you guys. As you can see, the total training level are different tiers. You start off with low tier titles, and you go up ranks, and it goes like from Saiyan to Kai level, then God level, and then Super, which is the last level. Meaning that for each level, each tier, you get new added lessons to even the ones that you already took classes from. So it has a lot of depth. Now, aside from the instructors, like I told you, you have the main story quest. Ah, of course, you have the parallel quest. And here are basically all the shops that you can come to for skills, mixing, clothing shop, which for some ironic reason, there's a lack of Goku clothing here. I don't know, maybe because they did so much of it in the first one. Have the parallel quest, which is basically another game in itself, because you have a ton of stuff plus the downloadable content, which is marked here by new parallel quests. These are the absolute newest ones, and the cool thing about these is that most of these have themes and characters and settings and stuff from the recent Dragon Ball Super story arc that's going on right now. So you can see here, you have in the enemy section here, you see Hit and you see Kaba. So there's a whole bunch of stuff here. You see, you have Champa here. So you not only get the new stuff, the old stuff, but you get a lot of the new stuff, as you can see here by Goku Black, which is in the bottom there, like next to Cell, and Zamasu, which is the first one. So yeah, you have a ton of quests, which I barely scratched the surface in most of them, because I've been focused in the story mode, except for a few, which I decided to play. I have S rankings here and Z rankings, because these, each one of them, depending on how well you do it, they give you a certain set amount of stuff as reward, like clothing and special moves and stuff like that. See, this one actually netted me the go-getter clothes. And once you get the stuff, how do you apply them? Well, easy. You just go into customize and you go change. You can change equipment, the skill set, boost the attributes to make them stronger. Make him or her, depending on the gender that you choose, of course. This is my skill set right here. As transformation, I have Future Super Saiyan, which I think is the highest awoken skill. So you can see here, ultimate attacks, stuff like that. And equipment. Here's where I have most of my fun aside from fighting, because I get to customize those sets that are allowed for you to customize color. But you can choose, each one of these costumes actually has bearing on how much you have in terms of stats and stuff. There's a thing in particular here, the QQ Bang, that gives you massive boosts and decreases some other stats. So it's a pick and choose kind of thing. Basically, you mix and match and set your character to be however he wants to be. Now, of course, the ideal thing would have been having the Super Saiyan 4 suit right here, which I can do, of course. I have the Super Saiyan 4 pants and Super Saiyan 4. See, all I need right now to make it a complete Super Saiyan 4 would be the tail and the hair, because this hair is not it. Now, what an accessory that I have here from Yarobi. Gajiro. I can get a little close to that, but not by much. I don't like it because when you transform, the hair does not transform with it. So I just leave it standard. So yeah, I have it right here. If I could color these sets, as you can see, it doesn't allow me to color it. I can make it exactly like the avatar from that I have from RCT. But, you know, it's good enough. Now, let's get into the part that matters here. Let's get into some fighting. Let me show you here, and with that, I will end this review. So, like, you have here online battles, which you can go in that I haven't even checked out, as you can see by the question marks. There's so many things to do. This is essentially a fighting RPG. And one that has a lot of Dragon Ball. If you don't like Dragon Ball, don't even bother with this thing. You're going to go nuts. It is fan service after fan service. Now, as you can see here, the range of characters, even the newest ones, Goku God, my favorite, Super Saiyan 4, and Transformation. But you have the whole gamut, even the Vegeta Super Saiyan God, Super Saiyan, Golden Frieza. Of course, a lot of these are with downloadable packs. You can have more obscure ones like Super 17. Classics like Broly, Vegito, Gogeta, which are transformations, and Gogeta Super Saiyan 4, which is really badass. And you have newer, most recent characters like you have Whis, you have Beerus, and you have Jaco. So yeah, you have a ton of characters to choose from. Even the ultimate badass Super Saiyan God Super Saiyan Vegito transformation between, or the fusion between Vegeta and Goku, and Rose Goku Black. I am not even gonna say anything about choosing rose color, pink color for this. I have no idea what bearing that has, but anyways, it's all good, all fun. So as far as who am I gonna fight, let's do Goku. Oh no, wait. I'm gonna choose my character. Now here it gives you all the clothing that you've set in the presets. And the stages, which I've unlocked most of them, I have a few left. But let me choose this one, which is the arena in the latest Dragon Ball Super, where the tournament is taking place, or where the tournament took place before the most recent one. I'm wondering if that stage of the tournament is in here. Have like it. Kaioken times 20 Kamehameha. Aside from all the story modes and all the stuff that you can do, you can also train, you can also fight one-on-one arcade style, as long as you go to this part of the map. So there's so much to do. I plan to complete the whole thing eventually. Like, you see all of those pink little houses, instructor houses, they turn into, as you can see, if you can see the gray star in the map, that's kind of a little shaded. That's basically what the instructor houses turn into once you complete the training. So yeah, as you can see, I got a few of those stars around. Those are the instructors that I already mastered their techniques and stuff. So once I finish all of those, I do the expert missions and so on and so forth. I got a whole bunch of stuff to do. So yeah, is it worth it? Oh hell yeah. For a Switch owner that's looking for something a little bit more meaty and substantial, I definitely recommend it. So, that being said, hopefully soon I'll be able to talk to you guys. I have in the works making a video of the updated SNES mini hack, so I hope you guys check that out as well. All I can say for now is thanks for watching. Please support and share and like. And I'll see you guys later. Hopefully soon I'll have some updated news about when I'm going back to Twitch and Hitbox, which I still advertise, but for some reason I haven't been there in months. So stay tuned for that. Just take care, guys, all right? Peace.